Midbrain is divided into two levels, inferior or level of inferior colliculus and superior or level of superior colliculus. Midbrain is made of tectum, the dorsal part, tegmentum, the middle part, while the ventral part is the basis pedunculi. Tectum, which is the dorsal part of the midbrain, it contains inferior colliculus in inferior midbrain and superior colliculus in superior midbrain. Tegmentum, which is the middle part, it contains the following structures present in all levels. Medial longitudinal bundle, three limeniscus, medial limeniscus, spinal limeniscus, and trigeminal limeniscus. There is the mesencephalic nucleus of the trigeminal nerve, the fifth cranial nerve. Then, substantia nigra, formed of pigmented nerve cells having melanin. Finally, there is the reticular formation. Basis pedunculi, which is the ventral part of the midbrain. It consists of descending fibers of cortical origin present in all levels. These are corticospinal fibers, occupy the middle three-fifths. They descend to the spinal cord. The lateral corticopontine and corticobulbar fibers occupy the lateral one-fifth. The medial corticopontine and corticobulbar fibers occupy the medial one-fifth. The corticopontine fibers terminate around the pontine nucleon in the basis pontus, while the corticobulbar fibers terminate around the cranial nuclei. Inferior midbrain, or level of inferior colliculus. It has dorsally the aqueduct of Sylvius surrounded by a nearly rounded gray matter. There is the deep origin of trochular nerve, the fourth cranial nerve, and the mesencephalic nucleus of the trigeminal nerve, the fifth cranial nerve. The tectum contains the inferior colliculus, which is an oval mass of gray matter and is the center of auditory reflexes. It receives afferent fibers from the lateral limeniscus concerned with hearing and from the cerebral cortex. It gives efferent fibers to the opposite inferior colliculus, to the tectospinal tracts and the tectopalpar tracts, and to the medial geniculate body for hearing. Tegmentum, which is the middle part of the midbrain, it contains, in addition to the structures present in all levels, contains also the medial tectospinal tract and the decussation of superior cerebellar peduncles in the middle line. Then there is the rubrospinal tract, and more laterally there is the lateral limeniscus, which is concerned with hearing. Basis pedunculi, which is the ventral part of the midbrain, is the same in all of its levels. Basis pedunculi, which is the ventral part of the midbrain. It consists of descending fibers of cortical origin present in all levels. Corticospinal fibers occupy the middle three-fifths.
The fibers descend to the spinal cord, lateral corticopontine and corticopulbar fibers occupy the lateral one-fifth. The medial corticopontine and corticopulbar fibers occupy the medial one-fifth. The corticopontine fibers terminate around the pontine nuclei in the basis pontis of the bones, while the corticopulbar fibers terminate around the cranial nuclei.
Superior midbrain, or level of superior colliculus. Dorsally, the aqueduct of Sylvius is surrounded by a nearly oval or bell-shaped gray matter. There is the deep origin of oculomotor nerve, the third cranial nerve, and the mesencephalic nucleus of the trigeminal nerve, the fifth cranial nerve, tectum, which is the dorsal part of the midbrain, contains the superior colliculus, which is a lamellated structure and is the center of visual reflexes. It receives afferent fibers from cerebral cortex, retina, inferior colliculus, and the spinal cord. It gives efferent fibers to opposite superior colliculus, tectospinal tracts and tectopulpar tracts, and the medial longitudinal bundle. Tegmentum, which is the middle part of the midbrain. It contains, beside the structures mentioned in all levels, contains also the decussation of tectospinal tract, dorsal tegmental decussation, and decussation of rubrospinal tract, which is the ventral tegmental decussation. There is also laterally the red nucleus, basis pedunculi, which is the ventral part of the midbrain. It is the same in all levels.
Basis pedunculi, which is the ventral part of the midbrain. It consists of descending fibers of cortical origin present in all levels. Corticospinal fibers occupy the middle three-fifths. The fibers descend to the spinal cord. Lateral corticopontine and corticopulbar fibers occupy the lateral one-fifth. The medial corticopontine and corticopulbar fibers occupy the medial one-fifth. The corticopontine fibers terminate around the pontine nuclei in the basis pontis of the bones, while the corticopulbar fibers terminate around the cranial nuclei.
Cerebellum is formed of two hemispheres joined by the median veins. Its surface is thrown into many folds. Each fold is formed of an outer cortex, gray matter, and inner medulla, white matter. Cerebellar cortex is formed of three layers. From outwards inwards, they are the molecular layer, is the most superficial layer that contains mainly nerve fibers. It contains the following: dendrites of Purkinje cells, the axons of granule cells, the termination of climbing fibers from white matter, multipolar stellate and basket cells. They are associative neurons. The axons of basket cells form basket-like expansion around the cell bodies of Purkinje cells. Then, Purkinje cell layer is made of one layer of large multipolar pyriform nerve cells. Their dendrites are highly branched in the molecular layer, while their axons enter the white matter to terminate around the cerebellar nuclei. Granular layer. It contains small multipolar stellate nerve cells. They receive impulses from the mossy fibers and their axons extend to end in the molecular layer. Cerebellar medulla contains only nerve fibers, which are either efferent, which are the axons of Purkinje cells, or afferent, which are mossy fibers, come from different parts of the CNS and end around the granule cells, or the climbing fibers come from the inferior olivary nucleus to terminate in the molecular layer, making synapses with the dendrites of the Purkinje cells. Functions of the cerebellum. It is not a motor or a sensory organ, but is concerned with refinement and coordination of the motor action, synergy of muscle actions. It is connected to the semicircular canals, utricle and saccule of the internal ear through the vestibulocerebellar connection. Cerebrum is formed of two cerebral hemispheres joined together by the corpus callosum. Its surface is divided into functional areas by sulci and gyri. The cerebrum is formed of an outer cortex, gray matter, and inner medulla, white matter. The cerebral cortex is formed of nerve cells, fibers, neuroglia, and blood capillaries arranged in six layers. From outwards inwards, they are the molecular layer, formed mainly of nerve fibers. The external or outer granular layer, formed mainly of small polygonal cells. The external or outer or small pyramidal cell layer. The internal or inner granular layer, formed mainly of small stellate cells. The internal or inner or large pyramidal cell layer. Then the multiform or polymorphic layer, formed of various cells of various shapes. Motor areas, however, have prominent pyramidal cells and less granular cells. The reverse occurs in sensory areas, where they have prominent granular cells and less pyramidal cells.
Blood-brain barrier. It is a functional barrier that prevents the passage of some substances as antibiotics and chemical from the blood to nerve tissue. It results from reduced permeability, which is the property of nervous tissue capillaries. It is formed of the cytoplasm of the endothelial cells. Lining the capillaries is of a continuous type, does not have fenestration. The presence of a tight basement membrane surrounding the capillaries. The expansion of neuroglial cell processes surrounding the basement membrane. The significance of blood-brain barrier. It protects the highly sensitive and vulnerable nerve cells from some injurious substances which may enter the bloodstream by injection. It prevents the occurrence of edema. This is because the central nervous system has no lymph vessels to drain the excessive tissue fluid, like elsewhere in the body. So the tissue fluid produced in the brain must be so little, for the venules only are responsible for its drainage. Cerebrospinal fluid. Cerebrospinal fluid is a modified tissue fluid present in the bioarachnoid space, acting as a fluid cushion, in which the central nervous system is suspended and protected, as the brain and the spinal cord. Cerebrospinal fluid is a slightly alkaline fluid, similar to plasma in containing the same salts as sodium and potassium chloride, but differs from plasma in having little proteins, sugar, and few lymphocytes. Examination of cerebrospinal fluid is therefore valuable in diagnosis of brain injuries or infections. Cerebrospinal fluid is secreted by choroid plexus and ventricular ependymal cells. Cerebrospinal fluid is important for the metabolism of the central nervous system and also acts as a protective device against mechanical shocks. Blood cerebrospinal fluid barrier. It separates the blood present in the blood capillaries of the brain from the cerebrospinal fluid. It is formed of the capillary endothelium of the continuous type, not fenestrated, a tight basement membrane surrounding the capillaries, the cubical ependymal epithelium.